Are you feeling this way too after a sunny, warm weekend? It's a little hard to come back to work.
Unless your wife had you working at chores, including gardening chores, all weekend. Actually, it was wonderful to be outside doing anything. News 5's Michelle Hopkins, who is never bossy, has tips on how to get your lawn into top shape. Michelle?
Oh, Jack, you don't know me. A lot of people, though, out scratching that yard work itch today. So I'm tracking down the lawn pros to help you get a jump start on spring.
Sunny and in the 50s, it's the kind of weather homeowners have been waiting for. The chance...
They hit you. When you're on the mower.
To spruce up for spring.
It's a big job to cut all those limbs out of there. So I thought this was a good day to start on it.
A lot of people are looking to start with the lawn.
I know we're anxious to get it green again.
So Bob Bard from Bard's Landscaping is helping us out with one of the biggest problems right now, ground spots. Yeah,
these are the spots that a lot of people are talking about right now. And you can see the lawn has just been just covered with snow for so long. Rake this up and remove as much of the dead thatch as possible.
Bob recommends overseeding when the brown spots are really bad.
Just going in overseeding, passing about 6 feet across.
And where you see leaves, Bob says you want to get to raking.
They're only going to mat the grass. They're going to cause a little bit of brown spots, keep the grass from growing, and really cause you to have some struggles later on in the season.
Experts say take advantage of these days. Dig into your yard work. You'll thank yourself later.
Oh, this is awesome. So you never know. Maybe today will be the day.
Today is a very good day, and this is a really good time to start planting. We'll let you know what and exactly when coming up at 6. Sheree? All right.